Introduced in the 90s, endoscopy becomes a very important element in the daily practice of gastroenterology in marine mammals. Voluntary endoscopy is the most important practice in the exploration of animal digestive pathology. With developing a voluntary endoscopy techniques, a new dimension in marine mammals welfare was opened. The non-voluntary endoscopy is a procedure that generates anxiety. Sedation allows a greater tolerance in some species, but in the case of the cetaceans is practically impossible. Today, voluntary endoscopy has become a procedure that facilitates diagnostic and allows avoid invasive medical techniques. Development of a training techniques based on relaxation and tolerance make a closer collaboration with the doctor, the animal, and the trainer, reduce possibly anxiety, and improve the results of the endoscopy. Always, for training complex behavior, we follow the general training plan with 10 steps. 1. We are focused on the training needs assessment. 2. We keep the animal's learning history in mind. 3. Objectives. 4. Training materials. 5. Developing the training materials. 6. Implement the timeline of training. 7. Number and time of the training sessions. 8. Implement the training. 9. Evaluate the training. And then repeat any step when it's necessary. Maybe the most important in the endoscopy voluntary training is the desensitization. It must be complete. It is not enough to simulate the endoscopy and work with the second person. We must work on what is really going to happen in the endoscopy time. Because the elements of the real endoscopy can make physiological anxiety. Elements such as water, air, movement, reintroduction of the endoscopy, prolonged periods of the open mouth, breathing with the endoscopy tube, and sounds and vibration of the endoscopy. All of these can be unpleasant physical manifestation and therefore try to avoid them. Let me introduce you to my friend Splash. Splash is a dolphin to live in Marmaris Dolphin Park in Turkey. Today, Splash is going to help us for training a voluntary endoscopy. In the beginning, as we can see, we need to reinforce the new physical elements, material to we gonna use it in the endoscopy. The presentation of these elements always is important. We need to extinguish any negative reaction to the material. In this case, the yellow device is gonna protect the endoscopy tube for any accident. Once the reaction is neutral, we put the yellow tube on the mouth. The variation in the amount of the primary helps us to keep the attention high. Other point too is important is to try to reinforce them when the splash breathe, because it's a sign of relaxation. We use the left hand as a reference to distance and flotation. Splash always try to keep contact with this hand. We use the left hand as a control, and the right is gonna manipulate the endoscopy. As we can see, we use a tactile bridge. And we use the yellow tube as a link between primary reinforcement and splash. The short periods without the stimulus in position and station teach splash to wait for the next element. Again, we reinforce the presentation of the pipe. This pipe during the training time is going to simulate the endoscopy tube. The yellow device has a little hole in the middle in which we're going to introduce the pipe. At this point, Splash needs to keep breathing. It's very important to teach Splice to keep breathing during the process and extend the time gradually with the pipe inside. As we can see, Splice tolerates several stimulus: fish around, the pipe down to the water, air, sun, and the cameraman. The key for Splice don't care what happened around is to we offer him many stimulus as possible. Splice is ready for anything to happen. He knows at the end the primary has come. During the training, when we move the pipe, we help Splash to understand the pipe always is gonna move. In or out, deep or short, spin to the right or to the left. And the pipe, as the real endoscopy, can put air inside to the stomach, can be water inside, and we can wait the time to is necessary for finish the approximation. The Splash good job must be rewarded. A differential reinforcement is gonna reaffirm him the assertive behavioral is the main goal. We are not looking to put the endoscopy inside to Splash. We want to Splash feels comfortable with all the elements around the endoscopy. At the end, the goal is not the endoscopy itself. The goal is the Splash comfort. The ethical aspect in our sessions should not be forgotten, so that with the benefits of the endoscopy, the animal's integrity is respected, and in addition, they are allowed to make decisions in relation to what they want. This regulatory element is the positive conditioning concept of voluntariety. Our endoscopy training plan has 7 main points. 1. Extremely positive hydration behavior. 2. No social disorders. 3. Get the dolphin relaxed by breathing. 4. Position, station, and prolongate attention. 5. Solid secondary reinforcement. 6. Position generalization. 7. Finish with magnitude. The steps number 1 and number 2 of the training plan happen long time before to try the endoscopy. Hydration in the high degree positive help to our animals to tolerate the future endoscopy. Also, to don't have a social problems with the rest of the community, let the dolphin work with trust and advance faster in the medical behavior. We don't believe the social position of any dolphin should affect the medical or any other behavior training. He is my friend Flip. He also lives in Marmaris Dolphin Park. Now we will see the endoscopy session and we will mark the steps that we have planned during the training period. The preparation of the animal for the endoscopy is according to the veterinarian. In general, a fasting of solids is approximately between 12 and 18 hours. The main challenge is don't make anxiety or frustration when we training with empty stomach and no primary reinforcement. Secondary reinforcement should be conditioned to a high degree before training for voluntary endoscopy. The goal is to improve the medical task without primary reinforcement for each individual response and to reinforce everything together. If the animal is doing endoscopy training and we observe it session by session improvement, we can assume there is a correct stimulation. In this kind of learning without primary reinforcement for each response, there is no escape or avoidance because the animal is waiting for the final reinforcement. As we know, are behaviors that when trained without reinforcement, the quality of the responses declines, and if the test is relatively long, can turn out in extinction. But to avoid extinction, the animal response is based in a programmed event, the magnitude at the end of the endoscopy.